Kia ora, good morning. Welcome to Wednesday, 3rd of August, 2022. Nice temperatures out this morning. It's going to get pretty hot today apparently, but we shall see. So roaming around, just looking at the pig zone at the moment and thinking I've got to go into here on some stage through the wild jungle and see what kind of vining plants we've got. You can see that they are starting to really take over. More over there as well. These are the volunteer squashes and tromboncinos that we have. Sadly, I haven't seen any tomatoes come up, which is a bit sad, because last year we actually had a whole lot of cherry tomatoes that just volunteered out of the ground. They were great, but oh well, it is what it is. We'll see. We didn't plan for a garden this year, as has been said, so anything that we do get by way of volunteers is just, you know, bonus fresh vegetables. Anyways, this morning's ramble. We're heading down next week for excavation, breaking ground, how are we going to put it? I just say breaking ground. So that'll be good. Weather forecast may have some thunderstorms, but again, you know, weather be weather, we won't know until we actually get there. So we'll see how that actually pans out. Got the drone out last night just to get some practice in, and flew that around. For those that aren't aware, we purchased a little while back a DJI Mini 2, highly recommended. Great entry level drone, and the Mini 3 has a better camera on it and controller and stuff, but it's also like quite a lot more expensive, so for the price it's definitely recommended, and it falls 1 gram under the 250 gram weight that you have required to get a license from the FAA to fly your drones, and you know, make sure you know how to interpret their codes and things. So there are still limitations, and I've got a friend who has a drone who's provided some advice. Shout out to Ken, thanks for that. But there's some basics, you know, check flight before you know, there's nothing kind of flying in really low over your property beforehand. We have a maximum height of 400 feet that we can fly up to, but we cap that at a little, which you can do, you cap that at lower than that. You know, just the usual basics, try not to get stuck in trees and stuff like that. But it's pretty cool. I highly recommend it if you can afford one and you have a use for one. Really very easy to drive, fly. But it is like driving. Smartphone driven, and the software just makes it so much easier. It's auto land, auto start, auto finish, and you get about half an hour's battery life out of a battery charge, which is, you know, more than enough time to fly the thing around, have some fun, play around with heights and camera angles and flyovers and stuff. So far we've basically just used it to fly down our property, and if you recall from kind of previous videos, we've got 5 acres here, but it's long, it's narrower and deeper, which means, you know, to get down to the bottom of the property from the house, you've got to walk quite a way, which is not a bad thing, but things are pretty overgrown at the moment, so this is kind of neat. Standing on the deck of the house and flying the drone down to the garage at the bottom, and you know, checking the fallen pawpaw tree and stuff like that. So it's pretty cool. Plans for that are probably pretty obvious. We're going to be using it for videoing the property, so we get aerial views. So next week we'll probably put that through its paces. Dawn is the one who's going to be primarily on site. I've got to work a chunk of the week. But the plan at this stage is we'll get some cameras set up and get some stop motion footage of things that are going on as best we can, and we'll get the drones up with the drone singular up to capture some aerial footage, so we can kind of hopefully watch it go from a whole lot of trees on various hills and ridges and things to a whole lot of trees with a big hole where the homestead is, and a whole lot of stuff piled up alongside it. So it's going to get pretty messy. If the rain comes down, it's definitely going to get muddy. Yeah, kind of looking forward to it. Oh, I don't know what that was, but that is a very noisy insect. An insect. Something had down here decided it was going to chirp aggressively at me as I walked past, so don't know. Anyway, hope you all have a great day. Another busy day today. A lot going on at work, so yeah, get into it and get on with it, as they say. Talk again tomorrow. Kia ora. Take care. Bye.